Tim Todd, the guy with two first names. 83-inch G3 TV, that's an LG, or native laser projection, Sony VPL XW5000ES, going to 120-inch screen. I don't know.
What do you think? Pros and cons then. I don't know anything about the G3 TV, so.
It's just their newest gallery series television that has to be wall-mounted. 83-inch OLED.
Okay. Yeah.
And then the Sony 5000ES. Sony VPL.
I mean, we already know. We've said this before, right? TV versus projector. Projector, huge screen, right? Huge image.
Right.
83-inch and 120, they're not close. They're not close in size.
I have an 83-inch up in the living room. It's pretty big, but
yeah.
It's not a 120-inch, you know, screen.
Yeah, so that's what you get with a projector. And then with the TV, though, like the image quality is going to be significantly more punchy. Mm-hmm. Perfect black levels, level if you have an OLED like Chana. Mm-hmm. So is this OLED, this G3?
Yes, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so that's what you get.
So it's retailing, the OLED is retailing for $6,500. The Sony projector is retailing for $6,000. So $500 less for the projector, but then you need a screen and you need all the other accoutrement of that, right? Mm-hmm. You need the space. You need at least 12 feet. For 120 inches, you need at least 12 feet back, right? For the projector to sit on the ceiling.
Yeah, and right? Also, I think somebody said it here. It just depends. Is this going to be like in a mixed-use environment or a dedicated theater? Because dedicated theater, you want to go projector probably, and then, you know, have an acoustic transparent screen and just do the whole theater thing. But if it's going to be in a place where there's windows and like light coming in, then probably a TV would be better, you know, more suitable. No.
Yeah, I mean, in our living room, the TV's on almost all the time. If wifey's here, system is on maybe 7 or 8 hours a day, minimum.
And
right, she always has something on in the background.
They've turned on so much faster. If you're
I'm not a projector person. I want to know that. What you got to like?
Bro,
is it like me when the snow's happening? I go outside, start the car, come back in for 20 minutes, and then go out.
It's not quick. It's a good, you know, at least 30 seconds before you see anything up on the screen, you know? And then if you know, hopefully the thing doesn't change to an HDR thing, because then it has to switch again. And it's also not like a TV where it just switches pretty quick. You know, I don't know. Maybe some of the higher end projectors are faster at switching.
Right.
But it's one of those things, you know, switching from 4K to like a 1080. If you have it, if it switches from those, it takes a while. Yeah, it's kind of annoying.
Interesting. Very interesting.
Laser projectors, Matt instant says laser on? Projectors instant. Nah, they're not instant. I have a couple. And I've reviewed a couple. They're not instant. They're faster, but they're also not instant. I think it depends also on the processor that they have in there.
Mm-hmm.
Because I had a Hisense one that was more expensive, and it switched faster. And then I have a BenQ one, and the switch is slower.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's one of those things. But yeah, still slow. Not like a TV.
Make sure to check out our audio-only version of the podcast at anchor.fm/dailyhifi, or just go to your favorite podcasting service and search for Daily Hi-Fi.
Oh, the like beans!
That? Like that? Looks good, right?
Experience auto audio magic. Look out.